Hi friends, this is Andy Vegan. I'm making walnut kale pasta today. And I first show you my main ingredients here. It's about equal amounts of kale, stemmed, and walnuts. Beautiful walnuts. They're not bitter, so I didn't need to soak them. Beautiful, you see they're light, and it's very tasty. A little more expensive when you buy them, you have a choice. I take the more expensive ones sometimes. I would want to soak them, and that's perfect. And these are about 2 cups, you know. And this has 2 cups of kale, and it's pressed, firmly pressed into the cups. Then you have 2 cups. So it's about the equal amount. I will bring that in my food processor. It's such a versatile tool. When you have one, you are really blessed. It's because it saves so much time. It's amazing. I have it fitted with the S blade here. That's for the pesto and for many other things. And this one is very good because, first, if it runs, it does not move, very still, and it can run for a long time without overheating. That's very important. For some things you want to make, it takes some time for them to process the ingredients, like nut butters or so, and then they cannot overheat, otherwise it doesn't work. So I put the 2 cups pressed kale in here, plus 2 cups walnuts. It's a wonderful combination. I love this combination. And I have a large orange here. I say a lemon here. It's 1.5 big lemons here. It goes in there too. And a large avocado too. That's the fatty part. And it's a little bit more creamy than the walnuts have fat too, but the avocado is very nice in the pesto, instead of oil. So much more healthy. It's a wonderful fat avocado, I love it. And I have 2 chili peppers here, seeded. There are some, maybe 1 or 2 seeds have remained, but just the seeds make it very hot. If you like it really hot, you can leave the seeds. And it always depends on the kind of chili you have. Chili can be very hot, you can't even touch it, or it can be medium or moderate. This one is a sweet one, it is not too hot. I wouldn't eat it like that. I mean, I could, but rather not. But it's okay. And 2 of them. And this is here garlic, yeah, 2 little cloves, and a heaping teaspoon of Himalayan salt. So this is my pesto. It's basically, you could say it's a kale with the guacamole, you could say, yeah. And the walnuts. So again, we have 3 parts here, yeah, with the different little ingredients, units. But it's definitely take 3 recipe. So I will see if I need some water to make it more runny, because I plan to do it on spaghetti or so, and it needs to have a certain texture. I will see what happens after processing. So let's go this now. A little belly dance, but maybe I'll come back in a second. You don't need to watch me all the time doing it. Was quick. I didn't expect that. Let's see if it's all done, or if I have to go on a little bit. Once the food processor works, it can happen that if it's not so runny, that the sides of the food processor, so the ingredients are pressed the sides up the sides. So you help it a little bit, bring it down with a spoon or so, and then you start again. Because you want the blades have to be in contact all the time with the pesto. It really doesn't take that much time. I expected it would take a little bit longer, but wow, almost done, I would say. The kale is so firm. I will taste it. And then I tell you. Always depends, but this time I take the scraper. Where is it? In my scraper. This is nicer for the food processor because it is made for it. It comes with the food processor. And the spoon doesn't really fit in. I'll taste it again. Maybe I have to season it a little bit more. That's always, you know, you have to decide always when you do it. All the ingredients are a little different. Mm-hmm. Mm. Mm. Wonderful. Wonderful. The more you process it, the more the flavor is homogenized, homogeneous. So the ingredients are separated a little bit. It tastes different, so each ingredient has their own flavor. And if we put it more together, the flavor is more oneness. And let's see after we process a little bit more, and then I will taste again. Yeah. So, yeah, we're getting there, definitely. And also the volume will change. It will get, of course, be less more it's processed. Looks good. Pretty nice. So taste it again. I put some more Himalayan salt. So I used 1 teaspoon. I will use another one. See, this is a heaping teaspoon. About one more. So I would use all in all 2 teaspoons. 2 heaping teaspoons. Yes, now it would do. It's nice and creamy. If I put it onto my pesto, on my spaghetti, I might use some water in the pesto. Let's see. Well, but first, let's see the flavor now. Mm. Mm-hmm. Mm. Yeah. The salt was definitely missing there. The salt is a story in itself. There is a certain amount of salt if you use salt at all. Otherwise, it's a whole story, different story. But with the salt, not as a spice, but as a maybe as an intensifier, you know, for the other flavors. It tastes more intense if there is salt in. It has to do with the water and the ability of the tongue, of the taste buds, to absorb everything. That is the story of the salt. It's very important in the system, the salt. It makes the water go and come and go to the cells. So we can't live without salt, but we don't need to have too much. That's not good. The salt has very complex functions, very important. So it reflects on the flavor. If you have a little bit too much salt, it's horrible. If you have too little salt, it doesn't really taste as it should. So it has to be the right amount of salt, the perfect amount of salt, and then it's really the best flavor. If you always assume you want to have salt. Otherwise, without salt, it's a different story. But I would say yes, a little bit of water can do here, just a little bit. Get a little bit more creaminess. One more round. To the amount of water you take, that's totally up to you. I'll show you what I have now. It's a real nice texture, I guess. Real nice texture. See, this is what I like here. It's my walnut kale pesto. Yeah, the pesto is very nice on any kind of noodles. Zucchini noodles, carrot noodles. Here is my result. I have two little containers ready for the fridge. And I guess if it sits for a while, the flavors would combine a little bit more. That's the kale is very tough, and the walnuts will soak, and they will give their flavor to the other ingredients, and especially the walnuts and the kale. So it might even get better if you let it sit for a while in the fridge. Thanks for watching. If you have any inspirations or any questions, yeah, please let me know. You can also subscribe to MD Vegan on YouTube. A pleasure to have you there. Get another recipe every single day and find me on YouTube as well as Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Pinterest. See you soon.